Okay, so here we've got a little graph above that displays the total cost C in dollars of renting a boat for H hours. So my graph's a little rough and I've labeled, so this would be the point 0,5 there on the vertical axis. It goes through 1,8, 2,11, 3,14, 4,17, just to give you some more points. So the first question here is, what does the C-intercept represent in the graph? Is it the initial cost of renting the boat, the total number of boats rented, the total number of hours the boat is rented, or the increase in cost to rent the boat for each additional hour? So again, it tells us that the vertical axis represents the total cost in dollars. So the idea is if you go, you know, if you rent a boat for 0 hours, you know, maybe you have plans to go and you don't get out there, it says it's still going to cost you $5. You know, after being on the boat for 1 hour, it's jumped up to $8. So the idea is the initial cost, you know, is going to be this $5. So answer choice A is clearly correct here. It's the initial cost of renting the boat. It's not the total number of boats rented, right? It has nothing to do, the vertical axis has nothing to do with the number of boats. It tells you the cost. Again, the total number of hours the boat is rented, that's answer choice C. Again, the vertical axis has nothing to do with the number of hours. It has to do with the cost. And D says the increase in cost to rent the boat for each additional hour. Well, no, because again, the C-intercept has a value of 5. And if we go an additional hour, it's only jumping up to 8. 2 hours, it's only jumping up to 11. So it's only jumping up by $3 per hour. So again, definitely wouldn't be answer choice D either. But again, if I saw this on the test, answer choice A, boom, and I would be on to the next question.